pure shock and fear. My children were literally 2 minutes away from coming outside to play basketball.
A mother says a drunk driver sped into her Cape Coral driveway, knocked down her basketball hoop, and took off. The driver is still on the run tonight.
NBC2's Trent Kelly is live from Southwest 29th Street, where the driver almost ran several people off the road. Trent?
Well, guys, I'm standing behind what's left of that basketball hoop tonight. It's literally left in pieces after a driver plowed into it and pushed it nearly 30 yards away. And tonight, one mom is on a mission to track that driver down.
Pure shock and fear. My children were literally 2 minutes away from coming outside to play basketball.
But tonight, their hoop is in pieces after Aaron North says a driver slammed into it before later taking off.
I told my son to run inside and go get my cell phone so I could start taking pictures.
These are just some of those images showing the driver, who North believes was either drunk or high.
Clearly, she was shaking. Just her erratic behavior. If it was a sober driver, there was no need to try and hurry and run and hide.
North, who's still too shaken to show her face, says the car became stuck as the pole was lodged underneath. That's when a man living right down the road came over to help.
The man got the pole unstuck from the car, and he said, "I'm not leaving. I'm just going to park the car down in my driveway."
But that was the last she ever saw of him.
I mean, she did a number on that basketball hoop.
Ed Ricci lives next door and worries what could have happened if the car had hit a person instead.
Right after it happened, three or four people with baby strollers came down the street. This is a residential area.
While North did file a report with police, officers have yet to track down that driver.
I hope that they are making this a priority to get this woman off the streets so that next time she doesn't hit somebody's child.
Now, I did reach out to police today, but they tell me their hands are pretty much tied here, considering the time that has passed since this incident. Pursuing DUI charges would be pretty tough in this case. The driver, though, could face a hit-and-run charge with property damage. It would be up to the officer to decide whether to arrest that driver or simply issue a ticket. Live in Cape Coral tonight, Trent Kelly, NBC2.